Good morning. Now we are going to see about the antimicrobial systems in milk. So before we learn, so what is milk? So milk is a complete source of energy and nutrition. It is made from species to species. Their nutrition components are ranges from species to species in cow, goat, buffalo, sheep and camel. So it is a white color liquid. It consists of water, fat, proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals. It possesses the lots of therapeutic value, especially it possesses the antimicrobial activity. So antimicrobial proteins in milk. So first of all, the composition of the proteins. Whereas the cow's milk possesses the 3.4% of protein, which was higher than that of the protein present in the human milk. So that is 1.1%. So six different types of antimicrobial proteins are there. So first one, immunoglobulins, that is antibodies, and second one, lactoferrin, and third one, lactoperoxidase, and next one, lysozyme, and next one, xanthine oxidase, and final one, N-acetyl beta-linked glucosamidase. So first one, immunoglobulins, that is antibodies. So it is the most important one. It is present in the mother's milk. So it is also called colostrum. It provides the passive immunity to the neonates. It is antibodies are normally present in the milk, whereas the mother's milk consists of more amount of antibodies compared to the normal milk. Next one, lactoferrin. Lactoferrin is a glycoprotein which is present in milk. So first it was reported in the cow's milk. It possesses the antimicrobial activity, especially against the E. coli. So how it infects the microbes? By means of it binds to the iron molecules. Whereas it binds to the iron molecule, then the lactoferrin makes unavailability of ions to the microorganisms. Okay, thus the essential nutrient was not get by the microorganisms. That's the way it inhibits the microbes. And lactoperoxidase, it's a glycoprotein. It is present in the bovine milk. Especially it infects the gram-positive bacteria. There are two types of bacteria that are present based on the cell wall. One is gram-negative and the gram-positive. So it inhibits the gram-positive bacteria. So it by means of oxidative mechanisms, it against the bacteria. So first one, it converts the H2O2, hydrogen peroxide, into the water molecule, and it converts the thiocyanate into the hypothiocyanate. So in this, the H2O2 plays a main role in inhibition of the such bacteria. Next one, lysozyme. It is also protein. It is present in the bovine milk. So it also inhibits the bacteria by means of rupturing the peptidoglycans and polysaccharides of cell wall. Mostly the cell wall is made up of these two layers. So this was inhibited, particularly the cell membrane was inhibited by means of the lysozyme. So the mode of infection of bacteria is different types, but the drug against the bacteria by means of inhibiting cell wall or protein or its genetic material. So in this lysozyme, it plays a role against inhibiting the cell wall of the bacteria. So in addition to that, it plays a major role in inhibiting the vegetative cells of bacillus. So xanthine oxidase, it's an enzyme. So far we have seen the protein, but xanthine oxidase is an enzyme. So it linked with flat globule membrane. In addition to that, it consists of iron and molybdenum. So it also inhibits the bacteria. In acetyl beta-D glucosamidase, so it also possesses the lysosomal activity, and it is largely present in the located in the mammary glands, especially in the cow. So this enzyme is protect uterus from the infections. So the cow uterus consists of some amount of pathogenic bacteria, especially Pseudomonas and Staphylococcus, and that was inhibited by means of this N-acetyl beta-linked glucosamidase. So And finally, coming to the uses and applications, these six proteins enhance the milk quality. Because of these characters, this milk is not only used in the dairy but also in other fields such as medical, humans and animal health. Because of these compounds, it won't easily spoil. And the main role is it protects the milk from, prevents the growth of harmful microorganisms. Pathogenic microorganisms are completely inhibited by means of milk. And the only info that normally milk consists of some other microorganisms, because included in the probiotics. Probiotics means useful microorganisms, which is good for our gut. Okay. Lactobacillus is normally present, but this is not at all pathogenic. It is a useful microorganism. So other harmful or pathogenic microorganisms are killed, inhibited, arrested by means of these proteins. Thank you.